In terms of what the perfect strawberry is, it's actually a very complicated issue. And you know, you and I will have different ideas as to what the perfect strawberry would be. But most people would agree that a strawberry that is sweet and that it smells great and that it has high flavor would be a very good strawberry. Of course, if you ask the farmers, the perfect strawberry would be one that they can grow easily and produce a high yield for the marketplace. If you ask the supermarket, a perfect strawberry would be one that retains its quality over a long period of time so that it has extended shelf life. So yes, it is actually quite a complicated question. It's not one that's readily answered.
My current research is about improving the quality of the Australian strawberry varieties. We are doing this in two parts. So I'm doing the chemistry aspect of the project, and Eddie Peng is doing the genetics part. On my side, what I'm doing is to analyze the volatile profiles of the different strawberry varieties we collect over different harvest seasons, and then kind of correlate with the environmental factors, which we pretty sure that affects the flavor and the taste of the fruits we're getting in Victoria.
The project involves several partners. Externally, we have Strawberries Australia and the Southern Strawberry Breeding Program, and the project is generally funded by Horticulture Australia. Internally, within RMIT, we have the involvement of biotechnology and environmental biology, this discipline, and also applied chemistry.
What we want to know is that how does the, let's say if it's a hot summer, or if there's too much of rainfall, or we have too many cloudy days, how the soil temperature affects the growth of the fruits, as well as how does the amount of rainfall affects the fruit quality? Because some of these varieties can get water damaged easily. We have set up a permanent weather station at our experimental plot, so we have different sensors for photosynthetic radiation, soil temperature, the air temperature, soil moisture. We gather those data, and we also pick strawberries every week. And what I do is to use a special GC technique called two-dimensional gas chromatography to analyze the volatile profile of the strawberry. And then what I do is to see how that information fits with, or varies with the environment for that week. And we kind of see how that varies across the season and see if we can actually make some kind of conclusion out of those information.
This research should benefit strawberry growers because at the present, strawberry growers are trying to maximize production rather than flavor. And that is partly because they do not really know what sort of environmental conditions are affecting flavor, unlike, say, grape growers who for many hundreds of years have actually worked out the sort of environmental conditions that they need to produce a good grape for winemaking. Strawberry growers do not have that kind of information about how to grow strawberries for maximizing flavor. So in terms of this research benefiting strawberry growers, we can provide them with this information, which will allow them to make better decisions and be able to actually grow their strawberries for flavor and for maximizing production.